So my name's Nathan Holland. I'm 25 years old and I'd love to share my hope story with you. So when I was 19 or 20, I went on this this journey of healing where I discovered my freedom and life and love in the gospel, and it was incredible. But before that, my life was actually pretty good. I had a classic, I think, middle class Australian upbringing. But things were overshadowed by being exposed to pornography when I was about 7 years old. And what that did is I remember being young and even just having thoughts that no child should have. I had an encounter with Jesus when I was in grade 9, but it was, funnily enough, that's the same year that it became a full-blown addiction. And I call it an addiction because I was definitely using it in the same way that I see drug addicts today or alcoholics. I was using it to mask my pain. And so it got to the point where I'm in year 12, I'm a Christian, but I'm really just living a very hypocritical life. And so I remember even walking away from the Lord, I thought it's better to just be a sinner than a hypocrite. So I remember just walking away. But when I was 19, there was this family that just took me in and they just started feeding me, and it was a counselor and a pastor. And they literally just started to love the hell out of me. I remember that they would be walking with me on how to cope with this pain that I didn't need to turn to pornography to deal with it, that I was actually able to tackle it head on. And as that was happening, I started encountering God in my bedroom. Someone said to me one day, like, hey Nathan, like, if God's there, why don't you just ask him and wait and listen? And I did that, and I was quiet for 5 minutes and just started hearing God speak to me. Alongside this family that just loved me, I started to just hear the Holy Spirit just speaking to me, just speaking my identity over me. And at first I just didn't believe it. So he was saying things to me like I was holy. It's been 12 years and I've had this perverted way of thinking in my life. And so I'd be thinking like, me, holy, like how could I be holy? But he was just so faithful and lovely and just kept speaking the truth over me. And so gradually I started to believe him and started to see it in my Bible that actually when I became a Christian, more happened to me than I first realized back in grade 9. And in Galatians 2:20, Paul says, I've been crucified with Christ. There's no longer I who live, but Christ who lives in me. And this life that I now live, I live by faith in the Son of God who died for me, gave himself for me. And I started to learn that those words were true for me too, that I have in fact died with Christ, and I'm actually raised to a new person, a new life in him. So ever since then, I've just like lived a life of hope. I've had joy that I've never known, been able to confront situations that in the past I would have just run to those painkillers that I had in pornography, but I was actually able to stand up and deal with them with joy and peace and the life of Jesus. And so that's been my transformation. That's my story of hope, and it's given me a purpose that I think is worth dying for. So it's definitely worth living for. The reason you don't have hope is because this world orchestrates itself that we can't see reality clearly. If God is real, he sent his son Jesus to die, then what he says is actually reality. Not maybe what I experience or what others have said to me. Nobody else in my life can actually be able to say something that overcomes what God says. It's almost like if a five-year-old came up to you and said to you, the moon is made of cheese. You're like, you have no authority on this topic. Like, you're five, I'll listen to a scientist about the moon. In the same way, when it comes to a human and their makeup and their purpose and their reason for living, the only person that has authority to speak into that space is God. So he says to that person that he has a life worth living, that he is loved, is so dearly loved, is made holy by the blood of Jesus, and lives a life of purpose. So to any young person who doesn't have hope out there, I would say to you that the reason why you feel like that is because you are not going to the one who actually has authority to speak to you. Only God has the authority to be able to say to you who you are and your purpose in this life. And he says that you are loved, you're made holy by the blood of Jesus, and your life is worth living in union with him. And you can live this life doing incredible things with him. He is the only one that has the authority to speak into who you are.